Well, okay, we have a War Thunder dev blog to take a look at here. I was going to go eat and do some things, which means I would have missed this, so it's a good thing somebody sent me a message, actually, because I wasn't even planning on looking. But it is on the Bagel Panzer, which is clearly how you pronounce that, 57, which we took a look at this on, well, I mean, of course, everybody else took a look at it on the dev server. I just took a look at a picture from the dev server of it, and holy shit, guys! What the hell? 16,000 views? Stop! That is ridiculous. I was just some fucker looking at pictures and talking about them. That makes no sense. I went to sleep and woke up and it had 15,000 views. I have no idea where the hell that came from. Whatever. We're gonna take a look at this thing now. I'm actually a little interested in this thing because of its cannon and just because it's German and because of how it looks. I like fast, maneuverable, and aggressive style type vehicles. And I heard a lot of good things about this vehicle, especially its ATGM. What happens if you install a rapid firing ship cannon and guided ro That makes no sense. The guided rockets on a light tracked chassis, the German engineers, of course, when doesn't German engineers do something good? That did so got themselves a very distinctive scout and support vehicle. Meet the Bagel 57, a light top tier tank in the German branch of War Thunder. Here's a little bit of history of the old thing. It's got a tow missile. That is the type of guided firearm that this thing has. Here's a picture of it, actually. Very beautiful looking. And that's a lot coming from somebody that doesn't like this type of shit. Like, period. Like, I'm not just talking about War Thunder, I'm talking period. do 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 ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. This looks really nice. Look at that. Looks almost fucking real. Actually, this screenshot really looks like World of Tanks high definition. I'm not kidding. Like, you show me this screenshot. This looks like War Thunder. This looks like World of Tanks high definition. Which is really good looking, is what I'm saying. I think it has something to do with the lighting that they have in this, because this looks like it might be the same. It looks like they have the same lighting setup. It's just on this side of the vehicle, and when they show it from that angle, I don't know. Wow, this thing's bigger than I thought it was. Look at that. Look at that tiny little dude. Holy Jesus, thing is big. I thought this was a tiny thing. I guess it wouldn't make sense because that's a cannon. So, and that's a YouTube video. Interesting. All right, let's go ahead and close this then. I was thinking it was like a little Hellcat. Of course, I'm just an idiot. In War Thunder, we've reserved a place at rank 6 of the German research tree for the Bagel 57. It's a more than symmetrical response to the Soviet BMP-1. The vehicle's main feature is its rapid-firing 57mm automatic Bofors ship cannon and a low-profile turret. Its ammunition complement consists of 96 shells in magazines of 24 shells each. A choice of high-explosive F shells, fragmentation, I'm assuming is what that is, solid armor piercing shells, and semi armor piercing shells with a ballistic cap is available. The armor piercing shells confidently pierce through lightly armored vehicles at any targeted range. In addition, you can bravely hunt tanks by aiming at the side and rear. However, for a guaranteed kill on more heavy targets, the Bagel 57 has an ATGM tow system with automated loading and high, or excuse me, far higher penetration characteristics. Of course it has that. I've heard it's supposed to be the best missile, like, period, so that's interesting. The armored vehicle's crew consists of 5. Somebody told me that I was gonna like that on Steam. I do, because any of the new tanks that keep coming, it's like less and less crew. Soon there's gonna be one crew member, because soon there's gonna be no crew members. We're just gonna be driving robot tanks in War Thunder. But because of how light the vehicle is, I don't think having more crew is going to make me happier. It's actually not at all. If this vehicle had more armor, if this was like, you know, a Leopard, or if it was like, I'm talking a more modern Leopard, or it was, you know, a T-64 or something, I would be far more excited, because that's something that I can dish with, not something that is going to get killed by a really small automatic fire weapon. And I'm going to assume that well, I don't know, because this thing is bigger than I thought it was, so I don't know if this thing's going to have the hull break, because Now that I've been playing the game a lot more recently with and against vehicles that are light and experiencing hull break both by doing it and having it done to me, although it's only been done to me a couple times, I've done it far more than I've had it done to me. I've noticed hull break can be really weird sometimes. Like, maybe at one point I'll shoot through an enemy vehicle, like a truck, and it'll blast through the engine compartment and blast out the back side, and it'll say, I keep wanting to say crew, it'll say hull break, which makes sense, because that shell would have just obliterated the vehicle. But then other times I've noticed, holy shit, there's one of those German 88mm half-tracks or whatever, and he's driving around, and he comes around the corner, and he's trying to get away from me, and I just shoot my semi-large caliber cannon, and it hits the back metal piece of his vehicle. That's not, it's just the little thing that hangs down. Hits him, and his entire vehicle instantly dead, because hull break. I don't know, it's really weird sometimes, because people asked me to make a video on that back in the day, and I never did, because I didn't experience it that's why I was worried a little bit about this thing, now that I know that it can be weird. I don't think it's going to matter. I think with all the vehicles at this top tier, it's more or less going to come down to who shoots first. It's more or less, it seems more and more that these high tiers are almost exactly like low tier. Because at very low tier, I'm talking low tier, tier 1. Because I've always stated my opinion on tier 1 is that it's not really that skill-based, because it's whoever shoots first is there. There's no armor angling or anything like that. It's not the case at tier 6. I've recently started playing very high tier and fighting against tier 6s, and it's definitely not the same, but it does follow that similar formula of now there's less and less surviving shots and more death, like more than tier 2, 3, and 4. I don't know, whatever. That's just my experience. Anyways, the armored vehicle's crew consists of 5, and its 2 loaders are in the rear. This non-standard solution will often save your vehicle in battle. I doubt it. The armor, as follows from the vehicle's intended purpose, is weak, but the Bagel can boast excellent movement characteristics. It has a maximum speed of 70 kilometers an hour, which is not the best, but is still extremely good. The Bagel 57 awaits you in War Thunder Update 1.0. Oh, of course, that's what they're going to be calling the update. I mean, I guess that's to be expected. You can try it out in battle very soon. See you later. I want this thing so bad because Germany, but I haven't been working at all on any of the tier 6s, so I doubt I'm going to get this thing anytime soon, but I can't wait to get it because it's beautiful. I love how it looks. And, you know, again, that's something that you don't hear from me very much when it comes to modern tanks. And I know I've explained this in the past. I've talked about so many Cold War era and modern tanks that I think are not pretty that everyone else does. Like I was talking about the Leopard 2A5 or whatever it's called. I don't think that's a pretty tank. I don't think the Abrams is a pretty tank. You can give me just about any vehicle of this era or the era previous to this, and the Cold War era, and I will, 99% of the time, I'm going to say I do not like the look of it. It looks ugly. This thing, however, I think this looks kind of pretty. I love it. So I'm interested to play it. I'm going to test drive it, of course. On the dev server, I think it came after the Yag Tiger. I could be wrong. If I'm wrong, feel free to correct me. I don't know if that's going to move around or not. I don't know if that's a good place either. I'm not exactly sure. They've been kind of putting the tanks in, like they put the MBT, or excuse me, the KPZ-70 after the mouse, which is weird. I don't know why, but they did. So I don't know what they're doing with Tier 6. They're kind of putting everything everywhere. Feel free to let me know what you think about this thing down in the comments below. I'm sure a lot of you actually had a chance to test it during the testing of the dev server, or opening of the dev server. And I'm sure a lot of you have seen a lot of YouTube videos on it. But that's probably going to bring this one to an end. So, another dev blog, very nice looking. In the meantime, however, tomorrow, I believe, is going to spark the first day that we can obtain the I-29 and M8 Greyhound. So keep that in mind if you are looking forward to collecting those vehicles. I believe, let me just check, I need to make sure, otherwise I'm going to look like an idiot. And, well, usually I do. Yes, October 31st, so that is tomorrow, and then on November 1st, apparently there's going to be special rare vehicles. I'm assuming that's like a war bond thing again, either that or they are just talking about these, but I don't know. It seems more like people are thinking more and more that this possibly might be more vehicles. Can't say for sure, though, but just in case, be prepared, because that's coming in 2 days. So if you want to have your schedule completely clean, get both of these vehicles, if you want both of them, tomorrow. It's super easy to get them. 5 victories with the respective tier and respective vehicle aviation versus ground forces. And I believe, as for, because this isn't something French, as for everything else that's not French so far, I believe there is only, like, 2 more things? 3 more things, actually. Those are the 2 Italian tanks and the Japanese production variant of the Hori, if I remember correctly. If I'm wrong, feel free to let me know again. Also, something else that I think is pretty interesting to mention here, most of you probably know about this as well, but I was notified over Discord by the European Canadian that there is also apparently a couple things that were found in the files, including a French bundle pack for the Yak-9T, which is really interesting sounding, so I'm curious to see why that's not actually on the dev server right now. I was also notified over Steam that there is a French P-36 Hawk, I believe, visible in the hangar screen in the background, but you can't actually, it's not actually on the tech tree, so that's something to keep in mind. It's possible that they might not have everything that they want to bring out and available yet. Just keep those things in mind, but there's a few other things too that vehicle related that I didn't mention here, but maybe we'll mention them in a future video if they get announced. I don't want to talk too much about it and sound like an ass when it doesn't happen. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.